Hi there, in today's video we're gonna talk about QNH and QFE. By the end of the video, you will know what the QNH is, what the QFE is, and you will know how can you calculate the QNH starting from the QFE and the airport elevation and vice versa, okay? I made this video because a student pilot asked me to help him on calculating these pressure references, so I thought to make a video might be useful for everybody, okay? So without further ado, let's jump right into the whiteboard. Alright guys, as you can see on the top left, we've got three questions, okay? These questions came out actually from the ATPL questions, okay? So, as you can see, they are all related to QNH, QFE and pressure references, alright? So, let's have a look on the first one and let's try to understand the questions and then the answers, okay? So, the first one says, if the QFE at Kourou, which is an airport somewhere, I have no clue where it's that, which has got a 660 feet above mean sea level, is 980 hectopascal, what is approximately QNH? And then between, and then it says 1 millibar equals 30 feet. Okay, the first thing is that 1 millibar equals 1 hectopascal. So that means that for every hectopascal of pressure differences, we've got 27 feet. So let's write down, let's make a drawing in here, okay? Guys, again, sorry for my drawing, okay? But my goal is to make sure that the concept is clear, okay? So this is the mean sea level. Let's make the terrain in there, okay? So this is the mean sea level, that's the terrain. And that's the airport, okay? So guys, the important thing is that it's clear, it's not a drawing, okay? So the airport can make the center line there. Beautiful. So let's say the airport elevation, as you can see in here, is 660 feet, okay? So the elevation is the distance, is the difference is the altitude, let's say, of the airfield, okay? Is how many feet is the airfield above the mean sea level? So the mean sea level is here. So if I draw a line in there, okay, that's the mean sea level, that's the airport, so 660 feet, okay? So that's the airport elevation, fantastic. And then as you can see at the end, it says that for every 30 feet, we've got 1 millibar. That means that for every 30 feet, we've got 1 hectopascal in difference, okay? So the difference in feet between the mean sea level and the airport is 660 feet, and the difference in pressure is, we take the 660 divided by 30, because the difference in pressure is expressed in hectopascal, okay? So since for every 30 feet, we've got 1 hectopascal, if we divide the 660 feet by 30 feet, okay, we're gonna know how many hectopascal of difference there are between the mean sea level and the airport, okay? So we take the calculator in here, and we do 660 divided by, in this case, 30, and that's 22. So if I take the 660 and divide that by 30, it's gonna tell me that we've got pressure difference of 22 hectopascal, okay? So, again, guys, it's very straightforward. What I did, I just took the 30 feet, this is on top of that, it was in the question, okay? It says, because every 30 feet, the pressure, if you go up, if you climb, decrease by 1 hectopascal, if you go down, increase, because the pressure, we need to make sure that we understand the pressure, if you go down, increase, and if you go up, decreases. So, since the mean sea level is below the airport, okay, it's below the airport, the runway, what happens is that the 660 feet, the airport, which is at 660 feet, is gonna have a lower pressure. How much, how many hectopascal lower? So we took the 660, divide that by 30, and told us that the differential, the pressure difference, 22 hectopascal, all right? So let's say, now, what it says the question? If the QFE at Kourou, which is the desired port here, I guess, okay, is 980, so the QFE, guys, I made a separate videos about that, but the QFE is the pressure at the airfield, okay? So QFE is the pressure at the airfield, okay? So the pressure is at the aerodrome, okay? So it's 980, so the pressure at the aerodrome is 980 hectopascal, all right? So the question is, what is the QNH? The QNH, and again, I made separate videos, guys, about that, okay? The QNH is the pressure at the mean sea level, so it's the pressure that you find at the mean sea level. Since the QFE, which is the pressure at the runway, is 980 hectopascal, and the differential in pressure is 22 hectopascal, okay, in this case, we can actually assume and say that the QNH, okay, QNH, or the pressure that is at mean sea level, is 980 plus 22. I add the 22 hectopascal because we are going down, okay, so the pressure at the runway, the airfield, is 980 hectopascal. Since we are going down because the mean sea level is below us, we need to add that, okay? We need to add the 22 hectopascal. So 980 plus 22, that equals exactly 1,002 hectopascal. And as you can see in here, there are indications that the answer, this one is correct, okay? So 1,002 hectopascal, all right? So when you are actually calculating and performing this calculation, it's very important that you understand that for every hectopascal, there are 30 feet in altitude difference, okay? Sometimes they say there are every 27 feet there is 1 hectopascal, sometimes 30, but normally in the questions you've got if you have to use the 30 feet or the 27 feet per hectopascal, okay? So it is very important to understand how does it work. That's why when you make this type of exercise, it's important that you actually make a small drawing, okay? Because that visually you can actually see if the you have to subtract, you have to add feet and so on, okay? So I hope the first one is clear so we can actually move on. All right, guys, let's make the second example, okay? As you can see, the second question says, an aircraft lands at an airport, airport elevation 1240 feet, 1240 feet, and the QNH is 1008. So let's draw down this first, okay? So I'm gonna draw the mean sea level in here. Here we go, beautiful. That is the terrain, okay? And this is our runway, beautiful. So that's the runway there. So the airport elevation, so the difference between the mean sea level and the runway is 1240, so it's 1240 feet. So if this is the mean sea level, okay, and I continue with the line of the mean sea level, we're gonna get in there, so 1240. The QNH, we said, is the pressure at the mean sea level. So the pressure in here, QNH, is 1008 hectopascal, okay? So the pressure at mean sea level is 1008. The airport elevation is 1240. So now it says, the altimeter is set to 1013. So the pilot that landed in here, okay, the pilot, let me see, I try to draw an aircraft in here, very beautiful, okay? So the pilot has got his altimeter set on the 1013 as a pressure reference, okay? So the altimeter actually is reading the difference from the 1013 hectopascal all the way up to the aircraft. But where is the 1013 hectopascal isobar? So as you can see, as we said before, with the if you go down, the pressure increases. If you go up, the pressure decreases. So since the QNH is 1008, the 1013 will be below that because we are going down since the pressure of 1013 is higher than the 1008. So we take, if the pilot has got the 1013 set, it's gonna be in here, for example. Okay, that's the isobar of 1013 hectopascal. Okay, so the question is, says the altimeter will indicate. So what they want us to know, they want us to calculate, is the wall distance from the aircraft all the way down to the 1013. Okay, so let's see how can we do that. All right, so as you can see, we know this part in here because this part is the 1240. However, we don't know this part in there, and that's the one that we need to calculate in order to solve this problem, okay? So how can we calculate that? As we said before, okay, for every hectopascal, we've got 30 feet in vertical difference, okay? So what we can do, actually, we can calculate how many hectopascal we've got in here, in this section in there, and then change them into feet. And once we know how many feet we've got in this little part in here, we can add the feet, the 1240, to this difference in there, okay? So it's quite straightforward. You take the 1013, and then you subtract the 1008, okay, the QNH. And that gives you 5 hectopascal, okay? So we said normally that for every hectopascal, we've got 30 feet, okay? Some other exam says that 1 hectopascal equals 27. So you really need to adapt a little bit because I think the standard is for every hectopascal is 27 feet. However, a lot of exercise, they use the 30 feet. So let's try to calculate the 30 feet, as we said in example number one, and see what it says. So 5 hectopascal. So since 1 hectopascal equals 30 feet, if you multiply 5 by 30, that's going to give you 150 feet in feet difference between the 1013 isobar and the 1008. So this is 150 feet, okay? So now the wall distance here is simply the 1240, which is the airport elevation, plus the 150. So 1240 plus 150 equals 1,390 feet. That's the indications that the altimeter will read. Okay, so if you look on the answers in here, we've got the answer number B, which is the correct one, and it's 1375. Okay, so is that for sure is the one that makes more sense? Okay, it's not 100% correct because in this example they might using a different, because as you can see as well on the question number three. The question number three in here we go. They're using for every hectopascal or millibar, they're using the 27 feet of reference. And the example number one, they're using the 30 feet. Okay, so normally they use these two, normally they use the 27 feet per each hectopascal or the 30 feet. Okay, so you really need to try to do the both calculations if you don't come up with the right numbers. However, as you can see from the answer that we've got, is the one that makes more sense for sure. Okay, it's only 15 feet of difference. If you would have tried to multiply the 5 per 27, it might have get closer. Okay, so that's a little bit tricky when you do these exams and these calculations. But the most important thing is that you know how it works. You know how can you calculate that and everything. All right, so let's do the last example and see if we come up with the right answer. All right, guys, let's do the last example. Okay, the last exercise. The last exercise says, if the QFE at an airport, which is at 200 meters above mean sea level, so the airport elevation is 200 meters, is 1000 hectopascal. So the pressure at an airport that is at 200 meters above sea level is 1000. What is approximately the QNH? 1 millibar equals 27 feet. So first of all, let's draw down the question, okay? So this is the mean sea level again. This is the terrain in there, all right? And that's the airport, beautiful. So the airport elevation, wow, the runway is very nice. So the airport elevation is 200 meters. So the difference in feet between the mean sea level and the runway is 200 meters. All right. So guys, it's very important that you pay attention on the questions of your exams, okay? Because as you can see, they're giving us the airport elevation in meters and not in feet. So in order to solve this problem, we need first to calculate how many feet are 200 meters, okay? So normally it's, again, there are some questions use a slightly different number when calculating the feet from the meters and vice versa, okay? But normally 1 meter equals 3.3 feet, okay? So if you take 200 meters and you multiply that by 3.3, that should give you the feet, okay? So 200 multiplied by 3.3, let me, right, here we go, 200 multiplied by 3.3, that's gonna tell us that 200 meters equals 660 feet, okay? So this is our airport elevation expressed in feet, okay? Why we need the feet and we cannot use the meters? Because as you can see at the end of the question, it's saying again that for every millibar or for each hectopascal, we've got 27 feet. So we need to use feet because we cannot apply that formula to the meters. Okay, we're gonna come up with the wrong number, okay? So now, it's saying the QFE, so the pressure at the airfield is 1000 hectopascal, okay guys? So a very useful way to remember that the QFE is the pressure of the field, you just simply take the F of the QFE, okay? And then remember that F means field, okay? So that is actually the pressure of the field, okay? So the pressure of the field is 1000 hectopascal, the airfield elevation is 660 feet. What is the QNH, all right? So we simply, what we need to know is just to change this 660 feet and understand, trying to figure it out, how many hectopascal are these. So we take 660 feet and we divide them by 27, because for every 27 feet we've got 1 hectopascal. So if we took 660, you divide by 27, we're gonna come up with our 24.4444. So let's 24.4, okay? 24.4, this is hectopascal, okay? So the difference in pressure between the airport and the mean sea level is 24.4 hectopascal. So this is the difference in pressure, okay? So now, what is the QNH? We simply take the QFE of 1000 and we add 24.4, okay? So the QNH is 1024.4 hectopascal, okay? We can call it 1025 or 1023 or 1024, depends on you, okay? So why I add the 24.4 is because we are going down, okay? So if you look at the answers in here, we've got the correct one, as you can see, is 1025, okay? So guys, this is really how you do it, okay? Read very carefully the question, okay? Try to understand if you are using the right, like meters, feet, and so on, because that's really a big trap, okay? So many times you are actually calculating your questions, your answers, then you come up with the wrong answers. It's just because maybe you're using meters and you should use feet and vice versa, okay? So this is very important. The second thing, guys, make sure you draw it down, especially at the beginning, until you actually understand fully what you're talking about, because by draw down the question with the C, with the pressure and so on, you will really understand what you're talking, and that will save you many times, especially during the exam. I strongly advise you to draw down the question, okay? If you want to support the channel, give it a like. I wish you a great day, and I'll see you in the next video.